Today, we're covering the 7.8 magnitude earthquake in Alaska, tensions rising between the US and China, a wearable air conditioner, and more. Welcome to the Evil Bits Show, where we'll keep you in the loop with six of the most trendy, newsworthy stories of the day. Let's get to it. Did you feel it? On Tuesday, an earthquake with a 7.8 magnitude struck just 60 miles southeast of a small town, Perryville, Alaska. This earthquake was so powerful that it set off tsunami alarms in Kodiak, which is 300 miles away from the quake center. Locals stormed to a nearby mountain, where they were met by a long line of cars trying to do the same thing. After reports that the first possible wave from the earthquake didn't materialize, officials retracted the tsunami warning. The quake's effects lingered, with more than 20 aftershocks of 2.8 to 6.1 magnitudes from late Tuesday to early Wednesday. I'm sure Alaskans had a tough time sleeping Tuesday night. Tensions continue to rise between China and the United States. Allegedly, the Chinese government has been stealing intellectual property from the US and has been ordered to close its diplomatic consulate in Houston. China isn't happy about it and vowed to retaliate, calling the move illegal. Secretary Mike Pompeo said, "We are setting out clear expectations as to how the Chinese Communist Party is going to behave. Closing a consulate is a serious diplomatic matter, and we will likely see the ripple effects for years to come." The world's most performance-focused gaming chair has been released, and it could be yours for a cool $1,500. Top-of-the-line chair maker Herman Miller has teamed up with Logitech to create a chair that is designed for top-level gamers. The chair boasts features like cooling foam, back fit adjustment, even pressure distribution, and an enhanced gaming seat. One of their main focuses was designing a chair meant for a forward lean while gaming. The gaming chair market is currently dominated by racing office chair maker DX Racer, but Herman Miller is looking to take that to the next level. It's tropical storm season, and the National Weather Center has its eye on two areas that could develop into storms. A tropical wave threatening the U.S. is producing a large area of showers and thunderstorms over western Cuba and southern Florida. Air Force's hurricane hunters are likely to investigate the area, and forecasters say the weather patterns have a 60% chance to develop over the next 2 to 5 days. If the areas being monitored turn into storms, their names would be Gonzalo and Hannah. It's the middle of summer, and what would be better than having a wearable air conditioner? Well, now you can! Sony has released the Rion Pocket, which is a palm-sized device with a silicon pad on the back that you press against your skin to keep cool. It uses the Peltier effect to cool or warm itself up by releasing heat. The Rion is controlled by an app that allows you to control its three levels of cooling and warming, and will last 2 to 3 hours on a charge depending on your intensity settings. The Rion is now out exclusively in Japan and can be purchased for 13,000 yen or $122. Have you recently lost any followers on Twitter? One of the many reasons may be that Twitter has removed thousands of accounts linked to QAnon. Born around 2016, QAnon is a group known for spreading disinformation and conspiracy theories online and acts like a virtual cult. With the popular slogan, "Question Everything," the decentralized group has been known to spread claims that dozens of politicians and A-list celebrities work in tandem with the governments around the globe to engage in child sex abuse. Facebook also has plans of joining Twitter to work on stopping misinformation that can lead to possible offline harm. Thank you for tapping into the daily news with me. Remember, you can now post your very own videos onto our platform. I invite you to showcase your passions, gain a new audience, dive into a new interest, and be current and start trends. Thanks for tuning into Evil Bits, and we'll see you next time.